Hi, boys and girls. Welcome back to the Parsha Studio. Today we are going to make mix and match leaf cookies in honor of this week's Parsha, Bechukosai. What's the connection, you may ask? Soon you'll find out. Here are the supplies that we will need. Two bowls, measuring cups and a tablespoon measure, a rolling pin, a large round cookie cutter, leaf cookie cutters, mixing spoons, and a baking tray with parchment paper, which is not shown here. Butterscotch chips or white chocolate chips, flour, sugar, brown sugar, oil or margarine, apple juice or milk, vanilla extract, cocoa powder, and an egg. Let's begin. Measure out 1 cup of butterscotch chips or white chocolate chips. With the help of an adult, melt it over low heat in a small pot, stirring constantly until it is smooth. In a large bowl, combine 1/2 cup of sugar, 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 1 cup of oil, and the melted chips. Stir the mixture until it is smooth. As for how these cookies connect to the Parsha, let's get into it. Imagine you get a remote-controlled car as a gift, and you have the best time playing with it. Back to our recipe for a moment. Add 2 tablespoons of apple juice, 1 tablespoon of vanilla, and 1 egg. Make sure to check it for blood before adding it to the bowl. Use a mixing spoon to blend the mixture well. Then add 3 cups of flour. You may want to mix it 1 cup at a time. Back to our imaginary story. You roll the little car over every floor in your house, but after a while, it starts malfunctioning. Something seems a bit off and broken. You can try to fix it by yourself, but the chances of success are pretty low. Instead, you open up the instructions manual written by the developer to see how you can fix it. The one who developed this toy knows the product inside out, so you can be sure that following their instructions will give you a solution for fixing it. Next, divide the dough in half, placing half into a separate bowl. Leave half of the dough as is. Add 3 tablespoons of cocoa powder to the other half and blend it until the dough turns chocolate colored. To make the dough easier to handle, wrap each half of the dough in plastic wrap and refrigerate for 1 hour. With the help of an adult, heat the oven to 375 degrees. On a clean surface, roll out each half of the dough to about 1/8 inch thickness. Use your best judgment, or if you really want, you can measure. Make circles with a round cookie cutter. Place the small leaf-shaped cookie cutter in the center of each circle and remove the leaf. For best results, refrigerate the cutouts for 15 minutes. Hashem, like the toy developer, but of course infinitely greater, created this world and everything in it. We are lucky enough that he gave us an instruction manual, the Torah. The Torah teaches how to live in this world that he created. In this week's Parsha, Hashem tells the Yidden that the key to the world is the Torah. When one acts in the way the Torah teaches, the world, and especially the patterns of nature, work properly, since the Torah is their source. For example, the rain falls at the appropriate time, the crops grow as they should, and all the natural functions of the world work properly when Yidden follow the Torah. There you have your answer to what these leaf cookies are all about. Leaves are a part of nature, and as we just established, each part of nature flourishes and remains healthy when we keep the Torah, the instruction manual for the world. Replace the space in the center of each cookie with a leaf of the opposite color, so that you have vanilla cookies with chocolate leaves and chocolate cookies with vanilla leaves. Lay the cookies on a parchment paper lined cookie sheet and bake at 375 degrees for 5 to 8 minutes or until they are set. Allow them to cool off and then enjoy them. And of course, don't forget to make a bracha. We'll see you next week.